today, we are going over 10 of the funniest comic book moments ever. There are definitely more than 10 funny comic book moments, just focusing on some of the most meme-tastic and gut-wrenching ones that I've come across. Hello everyone, Steve from Cantu Comics here. There are a ton of funny comic books out there, but even the most standard storyline can encompass some random, hilarious panels when viewed out of context. Let's begin. Coming in at number 10, we have Batman, Jekyll and Hyde, number 5. When solely looking at the two panels, Batman really hates ice cream, and especially people enjoying it. I think the teeth, hat, and ice cream flung up in midair really adds to the pure hate that we see from Batman's boot. These two panels are definitely taken out of context, as if you read the story, you would see that Batman has been chasing down Two-Face. Number 9 is up next, and we have Captain America, issue 366. You definitely get caught off guard when in the middle of an epic battle, you are being commanded to wink it. Even though Cap's shield is making the wink sound effect, you can't read this panel any other way, especially with bolded red letters for wink. This battle would play out a lot differently if he complied. Next up is number 8 with Batman number 81. First of all, I just can't get enough of Robin's pervy looking chubby face. Dick Grayson has come so far to eventually becoming Nightwing. As I'm still grinning, Robin adds icing to the cake with talking about staying put and exposing himself. I guess he can get away with it as there's no one there to see his chubby. Amazing Spider-Man number 215 is our number 7 top funniest comic, and apparently Spider-Man's ass is easy prey. I'm not sure if he's getting a colonoscopy or being hit on very aggressively. I'm not gonna try and guess as to what the splooch spraying out of his butt is, but feel free to comment below on what you think it is. I just hope Peter has good health insurance. Number 6 is up next, and we have another panel featuring an early Batman. Justice League of America number 44 starts off with Adam, Flash, Green Lantern, and Batman thinking of those significant others whom they have touched. Everyone is thinking of their wives and girlfriends, but the first person Batman thinks of is Robin. The setup is perfect as Batman is last in the panel. Batman and Robin have long been teased as gay, especially in these Golden and Silver Age books, but both characters are established as heterosexual. Batman has no time for the ladies. Action Comics number 337 is next at number 5, and it features some golden showers and Supergirl. It's not the best way to wake up after losing a fight. Golden showers to the face apparently can revive the dead. Please don't pee on my corpse when I pass away. As pervy as it seems to have golden showers embrace you, as the panel progresses, it was actually just golden nectar from a tree. I wouldn't know that though, because I was laughing too hard to continue on. Number 4 is next, with World's Finest Comics number 7. And we didn't even have to open the book to find this gem. No dialogue needed, just Supes, Batman, and Robin rocking their huge cannons between their legs. I love how content and proud Robin looks with his arms crossed. Even Bats gives his thumbs up in approval. Aside from the huge pocket rockets, the issue appears to be an appreciation and support to the men and women of our military. Detective Comics issue 571 is our number 3 top funny comic moments, and this features a very wet Batman. There is nothing pervy going on in the panel, but once Batman speaks, it comes out all wrong. Yes, hose me down now. Yes, that's it, good and wet. What would make this panel a number 1 contender was if the sound effect of the hose was splooge instead of swoosh. Come on, Bats, this is too easy. Up for number 2 is another wet Batman. I know, how can there be more? Well, in Batman issue 356, there is. This time the entire page is pure gold. This panel features a mind-controlled Dick sneaking onto Wayne in the shower. Aside from the visuals, all of the dialogue can be taken out of context instantly. Hold still, Bruce! I promise this won't take more than a few seconds. You're joking me. Yeah, that's the idea. They just don't make comics like they used to. Now, before we get to number one, I have a bonus entry to share with you. World's Finest, number 61. So what is the first thing you see? For me, I actually see Soup smiling at the ladies with a raging boner. It doesn't look like an overprint of magenta, but a pretty happy little Soups. Then, I look over to the blonde-haired lady who is pretty mesmerized with Batman and Robin. I really don't have to explain anything about this. Their facial expressions say it all. I know the real context is that Superman is too strong, that Batman and Robin are really struggling, and I mean really struggling, to get that seesaw down. There's just so much awesomeness going on in this cover. For the number one top funniest comic book moments, I present to you the most memed Batman and Robin panel ever. World's Finest, issue 153. This panel is so iconic that I had to purchase a copy for my collection. It's not in the best condition, but given its age, you're not going to find any 9.8s, let alone afford it. Meme lifespans are short, and I haven't seen this one being used very recently, but for comic book memes, this one tops it all. Memes are the gifts that keep on giving, especially when people spawn it off with custom copy. I even remember seeing meme generator webpages. To see how vast this meme has become, just Google Batman slapping Robin and look at all the images. Pages and pages of custom memes and even apparel and swag. It's a cultural phenomenon, and that's why I ranked it the number one top funniest comic book moments. So, what did you think of this list of the top funniest comic moments? I definitely had fun researching these issues, and I'm glad I can share these with you all. Do you guys want to see more top list episodes like this? Be sure to share below in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for more comic and comic art related content. Until then, this is Steve from Cantu Comics, signing off.